Good evening, everyone, and we are calling to order our meeting, Public Safety Standing Committee. And the first item on the agenda is public comment period. Are there any citizens, if you would please come forth, if you would state your name and share your comments.
Good afternoon. My name is Melvin Jones. I'm from 3rd District. I'm coming today to, I've got a couple of people in my neighborhood, excuse me, I got to go back. I've got a couple of people in my neighborhood concerned about the speed in the area. On November 6th, we had an accident where a cop was knocked from the corner of Fendall Avenue, about 40 feet down the street, and if it wasn't for the tree to stop the car, it probably would have been in somebody's house.
Fendall Avenue,
yes, sir. Intersection, right there. We can park on the street and all. And it knocked it from the corner of Fendall to the middle of the block. And that was on November 6th. The speed limit is posted 25 miles an hour. It starts down at the Burnham, coming down, going south on North Avenue, and then going north on North Avenue. The speed limit is posted 25. I did call traffic and ask them if I would put up a setup of radar. And I was told from traffic that they didn't have anybody working on Mondays. I never heard of that before, but you know, I can understand that if they're short. But then I was told that I get in touch with Public Works. But my thing was, it's not a Public Works issue, it was a safety issue. They've done it in the past with radar, and if the city needs revenue, that's a good way to get revenues right there in that area because people are speeding. I had a vehicle total loss this year, and I'm quite sure that Cadillac, that man has probably been total loss. So, you know, all I'm asking the city to do is set up right now. I mean, they set it up on River Road. They set the motorcycles up going down there when you're going across the bridge. I know that for a fact. I've seen them set there. So if they can do that, they can do it on the north side. Still got a problem with the drug issue. The guys, first of the month, these someone's coming around, see any police officers here. You know, so you know, it's like talking. I called the chief's office, I didn't get a response back. I think it was November the 16th I called his office. I didn't get anything back from him, so I guess we don't have the chief of police. So, you know, that's the main issue, is just trying to go ahead on and, you know, Ms. Trammell not here, but I want to tell everybody to make sure they got their smoke detectors. And just make sure you got the battery in it. And that's the main issue. Just, you know, neighbors are calling me and asking me if there's any way we can slow the traffic down a little bit. And I think we could do it if we set up a radar. It really needs to be done. Because, like I said, we just had a couple of serious accidents. And, you know, getting your car, you know, hit as a hit and run, and you can't find out who did it, you know. Can't do anything with it. So I appreciate the help that y'all can help us with. It's the 3700 block on North Avenue.
Mr. Jones, I'd like to say first thank you. And I would like to ask, we have a representative from the CAO's office with us to at least receive and try to follow up relative to looking at speed and other issues. And I do want to thank you for articulating on Ms. Trammell's behalf to make sure we have smoke detectors. We're coming up on Thanksgiving. There'll be a lot of them following on, so everybody duly noticed in that regard. So thank you. But if you would, seriously, if you would see Ms. Marable to see if we can.
Thank you.
Any other public comment? Thank you. Then the next item on the agenda will be the approval of the minutes of October 15th. And
Regarding these papers?
The frivolous amendments.
Somewhere else. Move.
Thank you, Mr. Jewell, and I would second. There are no presentations this evening, is that correct?
We did have a couple of expected, but due to illness in one of the presenters' family, we couldn't be here.
Okay, so they'll be continued?
Probably.
If appropriate.
There's the one about juvenile detention center, and Mr. Hicks one about data's about. And we had earlier discussed with folks from the SPCA about their concern in hiring a replacement director. I understand from administration officials that's a process of moving along, and that the SPCA is consulting as a part of that process.
Want to go to the papers for consideration?